Let's expand and simplify x minus 1 squared. So to do that, it's kind of helpful to think about this as x minus 1 times x minus 1. It's the same thing, we've just squared this. So this is a little bit easier to work with. We can use the distributive property where we multiply the first x by all of this, then we multiply negative 1 by all of that. And when we do that, we'll have expanded and simplified x minus 1 to the second power, or x minus 1 squared. So let's work with this. We'll use the FOIL method to help us keep track of everything. So we're going to do the first terms. That's the x here, and then this is the other x, the first term. X times x, that gives us x squared. Then the outside terms, x and negative 1, so x times negative 1, that gives us negative 1x, we'll just call that negative x. Then we go to the inside, negative 1 times x, that gives us another negative x. And then the last term, negative 1 times negative 1, that gives us a positive 1. So since these two terms here, they're similar, we can combine those. So we'll get x squared minus 2x plus 1. So this is what we get when we expand and simplify x minus 1 squared. If you factored this, you'd end up back with this x minus 1 times x minus 1, which you could write as x minus 1 squared. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.